Now, you've worn many hats over the course of your career. This one, as media owner, seems to have the country talking. Why, in your opinion, is South Africa viewing it as so controversial?
No, I think there is a bit of fright as well, because basically they know that the landscape is about to change. It's going to be business unusual.
What is going to be your first port of call, the one thing that you're going to shake up in the industry?
Look, I think it's really just the rules of engagement. I think one of the fundamental things that this table is going to do, for instance, as opposed to what others do, is to be an information conveyancing belt. We want to be that, as opposed to, we want to separate news from information. We're going to do both. We're going to do news, we're going to do information. We're not just going to be just news. We're going to have information as well, because South Africa is a developing country, so there's a lot of what is not newsworthy, but it's important information. So for us, we want to be able to convey all of that information to the people, and let the people decide what they do with that. We are the only people that understand that it's important to convey information, not just news, just information, to say this is happening. I mean, picture a situation where every day when there are bills that are sent to Parliament, we get that in the newspaper that this bill, but because if we don't do that, which is what's happening now, even with the e-toll situation, people just get told, get a wake-up call too late that there was this process, and yet it was all reported to media, but media decided to make it not newsworthy and not report it, and people lose out. So I want to close that gap.
The argument, of course, is that GCIS exists for that purpose, or GCIS properties like Vukuzenzele, for instance, a newspaper that is dedicated to that type of conveyor belt,
yes,
as you mentioned.
I want to take them out of business.
You do?
Yes, I want to take them out. I don't think it's their business to do this. I think their business is to generate content, and they should use information centers like the New Age and ANN7 to transmit that information. At this point, government cannot print Vuvuzenzele on a daily basis. Possible for them, it's too much for them to do. But they've got the content. Now imagine with a New Age partnering with government and being that conveyor belt, I think government would be happy.
Finally, Mr. Manyi, it really sounds like your business model is one that intends to completely shake up, if you will, the media space and the business space in South Africa. Yeah. Do you think the country is ready?
It will be ready. I think the country is ready. I think the country is tired of the mainstream media. I think mainstream media has made it its business to be negative. So I think the country is looking forward not to be given unnecessarily good news, but to be given the truth, the facts as to the true status of what is happening. I do not think mainstream media is doing that. I think mainstream media is cherry-picking, is pushing a particular agenda. I think mainstream media has got some kind of a symbiotic relationship with opposition parties. I think mainstream media is actually helping, if you like, to create the climate for a regime change environment. That's what I think mainstream media is doing. So I think we have a role in this stable here to reverse that. We have the role to educate the people, to give the people the truth. For instance, let the people make their decisions.